Hello students, hope all of you are fine at home. Students, today we are going to revise some important questions of chapter 1, that is transport of food and minerals in plants of class 8th biology. So starting from first question, you can see why are companion cells and sieve tubes called sieve cells? So because they arise from a single mother cell and they both are dependent on each other. So these companion cells and sieve tube cells, they arise from single mother, and these two, they are dependent on each other. That's why they are called sieve cells. Question 2 is, name two diseases caused by deficiency of nutrients in plants. So whenever there is lack of nutrients in the plants, they suffer from some diseases. So answer is chlorosis, and second is inability to reproduce. Chlorosis, you all know, it is yellowing of leaves, and inability to reproduce, they further are not able to produce new plants. Third question, which is an important question, that is distinguish between xylem tissue and phloem tissue. So you can see here the first point in xylem is it conducts water and inorganic solutes, means it helps in transport of water and minerals. It helps in conduction of organic solutes, that is it helps in transport of prepared food. So conduction of substances occur in upward direction in case of xylem, and phloem, in this case, conduction of substances occur in both direction, whether it is upward or downward. Third point, you can see it provides mechanical strength to the plant, whereas phloem, it does not provide mechanical strength to the plant. Now question number 4, also an important question, list the functions of diffusion in a cell. So what are the functions of diffusion in a cell? Due to diffusion, the substances, they get uniformly distributed within cell cytoplasm. So within the cytoplasm of the cell, the substances, they are equally distributed. Transpiration occurs due to diffusion. So transpiration, you all know, loss of water in the form of water vapor from the surface of leaves. So this also occurs due to diffusion. An important point is respiratory gases, that is oxygen and carbon dioxide, they are exchanged by body cells with environment due to diffusion. So diffusion, these are the functions. Question number 5, give 4 examples of macronutrients and micronutrients. Now students, you have to give example of 4 macronutrients, means the nutrients which are required in high quantity, and you have to give example of micronutrients, the nutrients which are required in less quantity. So macronutrients, you can see here, nitrogen, phosphorus, sulfur and calcium, these are the macronutrients, means these nutrients are required by plant in higher quantity. Micronutrients, iron, boron, copper, zinc. So these are required by the plant in less quantity. Now moving on to next question, you can see question is, what is transpiration? Write all the factors which affect transpiration and what is its importance. So answer is, for what is transpiration, the loss of water in the form of water vapor from the leaves of plants into the air is called transpiration. So whenever there is loss of water from the surface of leaves into the air or into the atmosphere, it is known as transpiration. So there are some factors which affect the transpiration. These factors are, you can see, time of day. Second is temperature, humidity, wind and light. Now see, time of the day means day or night. temperature. With increase in temperature, the rate of transpiration increases. Humidity. Humidity is the amount of moisture which is present in the air. So, if humidity is more, the rate of transpiration is less. Wind. If the velocity of wind increases, the rate of transpiration increases. Light. Light plays a major role in transpiration, as this light helps stomata to close or open. Now, the third part of this question is importance of transpiration. So, what is the importance? See, it provides cooling effect, thereby saving the delicate cells from the heat of sunlight. So, as the plant body loses water, it cools down and it protects the soft or delicate cells from damage. Question number 7, important question, distinguish between osmosis and diffusion. Now see, first point you can see here, movement of solvent molecules occurs in case when there is concentration gradient between two regions. So what happens in this? There is movement of molecules from a region where they are more in number to a region where they are less in number. Now here, movement of solute particles occurs when there is concentration gradient between two regions. It occurs through semi-permeable membrane only. So for osmosis, a semi-permeable membrane is required. It can occur even without a semi-permeable membrane. So diffusion, there is no need of a semi-permeable membrane. Osmosis, now see, it is very important point, it occurs only in a liquid medium. But diffusion, it occurs in liquid as well as gases. So this is a major difference. Question 8, you can see, name the carrier of food from leaves downward to the other parts of the plant. So it is phloem tissue. Already I have told you that phloem, it is responsible for conduction of prepared food to different parts of the plant. Now one important question, that is, deficiency of which nutrients in plants causes de-shaping of leaf. So if a plant lack one of the nutrients, it results in de-shaping of leaf. So which is the nutrient? Answer is zinc. So students, the revision part of first chapter is over here, and in the next session we will be revising chapter 3, that is ecosystem.